Hi everybody, my name is Hannah and this is Pepper and Pine, and I have a chalk drawing to share with you today. We are going to be working on the majority of this chalkboard today for that owl drawing using our Sargent Art square chalk pastels. You could see this set is kind of well used and well loved. So I've got my new set over here, which is a smaller set, but it does have landscape colors, which we tend to go through fast first. All right, so this was going to be kind of a complicated drawing for me. So I've got my sketch there inspired by this image in the book called Owls. It's by Zoo Books. And so I decided to do a sketch since I thought that this image was going to be a little bit complicated for me. I also decided to add those little owl babies up in the tree so that I have kind of a background image as well as the large foreground image, which is going to be the main focal point for this chalk drawing, and that's going to be the owl. So what I'm going to start out by doing, and this is not always necessary, but I did decide to do this, and that's to kind of make an outline. Now this whole outline took me 15 minutes, so it was quite lengthy considering that the entire chalk drawing took an hour and 5 minutes. So it's really possible that I could have omitted this part and just gone straight to the color chalk in order to do this, but I went ahead and I did this just so I could get kind of the scale of where I wanted everything. And I'm really pleased with the way that it turned out, especially the rabbit at the bottom, the tree at the top. I think the moon should have been larger, and I keep thinking about going back and making it a little bit bigger for us. But it is the owl that ended up being so difficult to do, and you can see that I am totally procrastinating on doing that. And I waited to the very end to do that because I just wasn't really sure how to draw this image to capture that kind of movement. Like, this is an action shot, and usually my drawings are pretty stagnant. And so to really give it that movement, I am definitely copying from the book, but also I found that this was really challenging for me to do, in part because you would think that just drawing a bunch of feathers was pretty easy, but it didn't end up being that easy, in part because I didn't have as much neutral tones as I would have liked in order to replicate the color that's in the book called Owls by Zoo Books. And so I end up using different shades of brown and white to try to recreate those different shades of tan and light brown and white and cream. And it looks great in the end. It just doesn't really look like the image in the book. All right, so this is as far as I've gotten midpoint, and my daughter already loved it, so that was really encouraging. So now I'm coming back in with the colored chalk. My son, who is 12, is there kind of looking through the book and is really in my way, but that's okay. This is what ends up happening whenever we're starting a new unit. The kids get super excited about the materials. They get really excited about the chalk drawing and what I'm going to draw. Sometimes they like to be surprised. They don't want to be around when I am drawing it. Other times they really are encouraged by the whole process and they love to see it from start to finish. But regardless, the children really love going through all of the books and the materials that we have because that really gets them excited for our whole unit. And I find that they end up reading more books at the beginning of our unit than towards the middle and the end. All right, so I'm spending a lot of time working on those little owlets up there in the nest. It was actually a little bit challenging to do. Because when you're working with a really small space with chalks, it's actually really hard to get a lot of detail, but I am doing my best to kind of give those owls that quintessential large eyes. And my son said that it looks like they've got little eye masks on or glasses, and that's fine by me. They look super cute in the end, and I am super happy with the way that that night image kind of comes together and how those little owl babies look in the nest up there on the tree, all cozy and warm, looking after their mama, going for that rabbit that is going to be running across the field down at the bottom with some grass around it. All right, so there's that moon, which I think should have been a little bit larger, and I'm trying to do kind of highlights on the tree branch to make it look like the moon is reflecting on the tree branch, but I didn't do so great with that, and I think a little bit would have gone a long way, so less is better than more in this case. But again, once the whole chalk drawing is done, I don't usually go back and make changes and fix those little details. It's usually something that your eyes just kind of overlook in the end, but if it is something that does bother you, by all means, it's chalk. It's very easy to erase. All right, so now I am spending a long time working on that owl. I am both looking at my sketch a little bit as well as the book called Owls, and I am trying to recreate the wing pattern or the feather pattern on the wing, and it is really, really hard to do. So I'm going to be doing a couple of things. One is I put a base layer of chalk, which in this case it looks like a creamy yellow. Then I'm coming back in to kind of smudge it out, and then I'm coming back in again to kind of outline it, give it more color, and then to give it the detail that you're going to see me do more towards the end. I have a lot of trouble doing the body of the owl as well as the face, which I end up erasing probably 3 or 4 or even 5 times before I get it right. There's a lot that needs to go into making this look authentic and kind of giving it that movement that you really want to capture for an image like this. And in part, it requires some detail work that, again, is super hard to get with chalk, at least in my experience, and at least working with the square chalk pastels. It's possible that if you have more of like pen chalks, you can get a better, work those details a little bit better. But overall, for this large chalk drawing, I think that the detail is good enough, and you're not going to be able to see some of those flaws later on. So I'm coming back in to kind of smudge everything around the image and to smudge the color also within the image. Now, I ended up doing that after I painted this chalkboard. It was a slate chalkboard that I painted with some chalkboard paint several years ago. After having had the chalkboard for several years, I found that the chalkboard just got a little bit too smooth and wasn't holding the chalk very well. And it was really frustrating doing our chalk drawings because the chalk just would fall right off. So I went ahead and I painted it, but I didn't do a great job painting it, and I kind of had a lot of brush strokes and roller marks. And so by smudging the color into those different crevices, I find that it gives like a nice even tone, and then you don't really see my mistakes when I painted this chalkboard a few years ago. All right, so now I am working on that rabbit down below, which I think the head is a little bit too oblong for this rabbit, but that's okay. All of those minor flaws aren't really noticeable in the end. Okay, so I am going to go back and forth between working on the head and then the wings and adding a little bit of touch-ups to my rabbit. And this is pretty typical when I am doing a chalk drawing, or really any drawing for that matter. I tend to work on the things that are easiest first and then go into the things that are a little bit challenging. And when I hit a roadblock, I move on to something that's a little bit easier and then come back to the things that are challenging, just because sometimes that frustration kind of creates a roadblock. All right, so now I can kind of see the light at the end of the tunnel, and I'm working on the last set of wings on this bird, and I am adding those details that really make it look like wings and really make this whole image complete. And the very last thing I'm going to do is add that grass around the rabbit, and I think that that's the finishing touch that really pulls this whole chalk drawing together. That's it for this half of the chalkboard. If you want to see what I end up doing on the right side of the chalkboard, those videos are linked at the end of this video as well as down in the description box below. It makes a huge mess. There was quite a lot of chalk dust to clean up afterwards. And if you want to check out the materials that I used, as well as more information about the main lesson blocks that accompany this chalk drawing, you can find it on my website at pepperandpine.com. And if you want to see what we're up to on a daily basis, you can find me on Instagram at pepperandpine.